progress or the development today, who can probably provide guidance and inspiration to the new graduates? They believe that our colleague, Congressman Bataoil, will be among the top of those who are competent to provide advice. I'd like to congratulate him. And on that note, I also would like to note that probably today the PMA graduate is especially those who have gone through the slings and arrows of the career in the military are among those who are not very well understood or sometimes misunderstood in their role in governance, public order, in leading our country to development and success. It is very unfortunate that if we look at the papers, sometimes what are highlighted are problems that some of the graduates will encounter, but it's not the overall achievement of PMA as a class, as a community, and as an institution. Especially if we go back to the early episodes of our history. May I know if our distinguished colleague shares this concern on the part of this presentation?
Yes, Madam Speaker, I share the concern. I'm aware of the many issues, problems, and concerns which were highlighted in various occupations.
Not only in the case of the military academy, but also similar institutions in other countries, Madam Speaker. May I know if our Muslim colleague shares this view on the part of this representation?
Yes, Madam Speaker, I share the view. That's why I always advocated for the ample preparation of these new graduates before they will be brought there right on the front line to prepare their minds while they are physically to handle the challenges of their profession. Their mind and their feelings and their emotions must be properly guided by officers and even us colleagues and our political leaders out there in the field, out there in our very districts. That's why I'm hosting this March 23. I am hosting a get together for the Pangas Agency new graduates, class of 2012, together with my governor, who is also an alumnus of the academy, so that we'll be able to guide them properly and encourage them to do the right thing out there in the field and ensure that the good name of the Philippine Military Academy will not be stained. So I could share with you
and probably, Madam Speaker, maybe the public can be enlightened on the very distinct and a very eloquent alma mater song of the Military Academy, which he asked me really translates in very emotional terms what should guide the PMA alumnus in the pursuit of his or their career. For example, note one stanza. I may quote the speaker, the singer's belief. Wherever we may be, or land, or deep to sea, we'll raise a song for thee, Academy, Rail, Boutique. I'm familiar with some alma mater songs, but this line is indeed very eloquent, and it really touches the heart, and it instilled in the heart and mind of the PMA alumnus, and really guided to the true and dedicated performance of his or her duty. Would you agree, Madam Speaker, this is Ms. Bulim from Professor Dan?
Yes, Madam Speaker, I fully subscribe to that. In fact, as you mentioned those words, I feel the very essence of those words of the lyrics of our alma mater song. And if I may add, the last stanza of that goes something like, "One bells for us around and our last touch is sung." Let generations see our country free.
And then there's even a prayer within the song. When may thy sons ever be men of integrity, courage, and loyalty. PMA, who hail to thee. It's both an admonition and a prayer that the graduates remain steadfast, keeping with the words of integrity, courage, integrity, and loyalty. And then, of course, the final stanza. O lead us, O lead the righteous way, those solid ranks of gray, thy virtues to display, Academy, O hail to thee. I cannot think of any lines of eloquent like this that if followed the letter by a graduate would really, I may hope, lead the right way
that.
And by doing so, lead the country also, right this way. Speaker,
I believe that every autonomous academy has internalized those very leading of leadership, and they carry those virtues out there whenever they are assigned over landlord inclusive operating rule, serving our very people. And I believe that they are prepared to risk their life, even give up their life, a supreme sacrifice for country.
Thank you. Finally, Madam Speaker, distinguished colleagues, I remember very clearly this song was put to a test of how effective it can be in leading to righteous way the alumni of the Military Academy. I remember during the days from February 22 up to the culmination of the ETSA 1986 revolution up to February 25, Radio Veritas kept playing and replaying this song because of the fear that there would be a confrontation between the PMA graduates from both sides of the political spectrum at the time. One side, entrenched in Kamurabe, and another side, entrenched in Kanyama. I think the song played a very effective role in making sure that while there were divisions in opinion, in the end, it was love of country and patriotism that decided the day and decided the outcome of the ETSA 1986 revolution. On that note, Madam Speaker, and distinguished colleague, I'd like to congratulate again our very distinguished colleague and one of the most distinguished alumni of the Philippine Military Academy today, Congressman Pol Bataoil, class of 1976. Thank you very much.
Majority Leader.
Thank you.
Madam Speaker, I move that we refer the privileged speech of the Honourable.